Zombie apocalypse.
Okay, so this time collapse mechanism applied naman sa restrained beam. So using the concept of application ng uniformly distributed load. So let's get ready to be neurorized. So we have this restrained beam given in dead load and live load. And we have to identify the plastic moment of the given beam span. So span is 9 meters. So dahil identify naman dead load and live load, so we need to understand load combinations. Ito yung dead load alone, no? And this is dead load and live load. Based on the past video lecture na diniscuss ko, bakit nagkaroon ng ganito. Then choosing the largest, we choose 44.4 among the two. So again, ulitin ko lang, pag hindi in-identify of what type of load yung binigay, you say W of 30 kilonewton per meter or binigay na P of 15 kilonewton, 150 kilonewton, pag hindi sinabi yung nature niyan, automatic na nominal yan. So don't factor it. Huwag ka na mag-multiply ng 1.2, 1.4 whatsoever because hindi mo identify kung dead load or live load or what type of load is that. So diretso ka na sa load description. At don't multiply phi kapag naka-nominal na. So nagmumultiply lang tayo ng phi kapag nanggagaling muna sa ultimate. Kasi requirement ni LRFD na naka-ultimate siya pag galing sa LRFD. And then, ang analogy ng plastic moment, kailangan ibalik mo muna siya into a nominal state. So, notice that all plastic hinges in the collapse mechanism diagram are found on point A, kasi fixed support, on point B, and also on the point of collapse that we don't know kung ito ba'y nasa gitna. So, i-assign ko siya as X. So, but of course, due to symmetry, na support, we can expect that X is L over 2. But sige, prove natin. Kasi nagkaroon ng point of symmetry. Okay? So again, producing the same, we will get the following items of calculation. Plastic deviatoric slope, theta sub A, theta B, the plastic deflection, okay, delta. And then finally, we can proceed with the small angle theorem. So by observation, we can correlate that theta sub A is delta over X and theta B is delta over L minus X. Then delta is theta sub AX equals theta B times L minus X since delta is the same by these two. So finally, I can correlate theta A in terms of theta B. That's my choice. Also, we can say that it is L over X minus 1 of theta B. Then finally, delta theta P is to take the sum of theta A and theta B. So we will arrive to L over X theta B as shown. Now, use the virtual work method. Again, concept is, again, for review, Pn over 2 delta. Bakit Pn over 2 yan? Kapag uniform distributed. So, let's go back to the description. So, kung meron kang load at under nominal, so nominal ang description naman natin, so meron equivalent yan na resultant load, Wn times L. But we need to transcribe that it is separately taken into half yung loading kahit asymmetrical yung load positioning. Okay, so therefore, there is two possible allocation, which is, the first is, I'll try to not mark it red para iba namang markings, say blue, so meron ka dito Pn over 2, and the other one is also Pn over 2. Ang need natin i-understand itong tigkisang kalahati na yan, same lang din naman. Kaya naging kalahati kasi dinidistribute ng resultant load, yung load kasi, na meron talagang load per linear distance at any given point. Kaya we will try to understand it is Pn over 2 times delta. Then finally, we can correlate P in terms of Pu. Okay, so ito yung mga nangyari na dito. And then Pn is Wn L over 2 delta. And then ito na yung nakikita nyo dito. And then Wn is Wn is equal to W over 0.9, which is phi is 0.9 times L. Okay? Then finally, notice that theta sub A, theta B, and delta theta P are not zero because they are all plastic hinges. So nag-exist yung values natin, no? Na lahat sila is nag-exist na as a value. Yan. And this one is that one. Okay? So therefore, if that is in terms of theta b, so pwersado ako yung delta natin, gagamitin ko yung function ng theta b. Okay? Para makancel out. And then finally, you will get this one, no, makakancel out yung 1 dito, kasi negative 1 plus 1. Then L over x plus L over x is simply 2L over x. Okay? Now, if I multiply these both sides by x over 2L, then ito yung lalabas. So, L over L is cancelled. Now, may kinancel tayong L dito. And then, finally, ito yung working equation natin sa plastic moment in terms of x. Again, since 5W u over 18 is a constant, and L is also a constant, notice, I want you to see this, no? Yung xL squared minus x squared is again an equation of parabola. So, we will observe na naman, no? Collapse mechanism under parabolic shape. So, same definition, dahil parabolic yan, so meron siyang maxima minima again, and the plastic slope is said to be zero. Kaya that's why if we take the differential equation of plastic moment with respect to x, so ganito po yung mangyayari. And then finally, if you multiply it by a constant of 18 over 5WU, mawawala yan, masi-zero out. And then again, you will notice L minus 2x is equal to 0. Now then, we can prove again that x is equal to L over 2 due to point of symmetry. So, ibig sabihin, si plastic moment at si maximum moment will coincide again. Pati si maximum deflection at si maximum plastic deflection. By plugging in, you can derive as 5WU L squared over 72. Now, if you replace WU as VW sub n, okay, where V is 0.9, then you will notice that you will get WN L squared over 16. Now, ang mapapansin nyo naman dito, kahit under nominal na siya, hindi siya nagkakaroon ng parehas na maximum moment kapag restrained beam under elastic theory. Tingnan natin kung bakit ko nasabi yan. But before that, no, makukumpit na natin yan. Now, supplying WUU, so we will get 249.75 kilonewton meter or simply 999 over 4 kilonewton meter. So this is the answer, no, as the plastic moment. Pero tingnan natin, compare na natin to sa condition ng elastic theory. Okay, so focus kayo dito, no, sa plastic moment na WNL squared over 16. Kasi the load should be converted immediately into ultimate. Kaya ako lang ginagamit itong isang equation na to, yung binibilang ako ng huli ngayon, because madali siya ma-plugin kung W sub U agad na ko-compute. Pero originally, the load should be in terms of nominal. No, no worries about that. Basta alam mo kung nasa nominal ka ba or nasa ultimate. Kapag nominal, gamitin mo yung una. Ito. Kapag nasa nominal na yung load mo, ito gamitin mo, yung pangalawa. So, be careful. You can derive it direct naman, no? By plugging in. So, sige, let's try to show that na talaga nag-i-equal sila. So, again, notice that theta sub A, no, is delta over, say, 4.5. Kasi half of 10 is 4.5. And theta B is also delta over 4.5. And notice that theta sub A is equal to theta B kasi similar yung proportioning. And therefore, we can safely say that delta theta P is just only, let's say, 2 theta A or 2 theta B. Ngayon, we can now understand that WN over 2L delta equals sa plastic moment, then theta sub A plus delta theta P plus theta B. No? So, W sub N is WU, which is, ang value natin is 44.4 over 0.9, tapos ang span mo is 9 over 2, at yung delta, interpret na lang natin in terms of theta sub A. Kasi naka 2 theta A naman, yung delta theta P. So, I will choose to correlate this one. So, 4.5 of theta A equals plastic moment multiplied by, lahat may value yan, ano? 4.5 theta sub A, yan, plus 2 theta sub a for the plastic deflectoric slope plus theta b as theta sub a. So, ganyan. So, lalabas that this is 4 theta sub a times the plastic moment. So, obviously, we can now cancel theta sub a. Now, by calculation, 44.4 divided by 0.9 times 9 divided by 2 times 4.5 divided by 4. So, plastic moment under that case is 999 over 4 kilonewton meter. So, notice they are the same answer. Okay? So, I just showed you lang naman kung paano nangyari yan. Now, going back to the moment diagram. Okay? So, yan binilugan ko ng huli. So, in your theory of structures, na-discuss na po ito that it is WL squared over 12 sa moment reaction sa dalawa. Okay? But in terms of ultimate yan, kasi ang load natin ang galing saan? Sa ultimate. So, again, kailangan natin i-go back siya sa nominal. So, this will become, no, this 2. I-divide mo na lang sa 0.9 para maging nominal yung moment. So, divide by 0.9, it's 333. Okay? Ito, this one is 333. And this one, i-divide mo na sa 0.9 para maging nominal. Bakit i-divide? Kasi tandaan po ninyo, no, ultimate is equal to phi times nominal. So, the nominal moment can be calculated as the ultimate moment over 0.9. Ito yung ultimate moment, yung factored na pinanggalingan ng W sub U, which is under load combination. So, 149.85 divided by 0.9. So, we will get 166.85. Ang ibig sabihin po nito, magsasabay, dahil mas malaki yung moment na magkabilang dulo, parehas na mauunang mag-deflect, okay, at magkaroon ng collapse, yung magkabilang dulo at susunod yung nasa gitna. Yan yung procedure. Okay? That's how we define it. Ngayon, paano kaya yung diagram of collapse? Okay? Yung pinaka-plastic moment diagram of collapse. So, sige, let us try to erase this and then compare kung ano yung mangyari. Now, if you recall kanina, dinerive natin yung MP na meron kang x minus x squared equation-like sa internal form niya or internal equation. Meaning, that is a true parabolic. So, by this, we can safely say, we can now safely draw that the beam will deflect like this. I mean, we will behave as plastic moment diagram like this. So, this is a plastic moment diagram in comparison to this moment diagram in terms of elastic theory. Na ganun din. Ngayon, dahil nagkaroon ng plastic moment, yung A, yung B, at yung C, ganun din dito. Si A, si B, at yung letter ko na C. Ngayon, all of these three, ang equivalent, ang function niya, or equation niya is also plastic moment. As clearly as that. So, that's how we compare it with a moment diagram. So, ito yung pinaka-meaning nung kinumpit natin na 249.75. So, they will all perform collapse condition if you achieve a plastic moment of 249.75. Thanks for viewing. I hope you learned something new today. So, next video lecture, what if we have multiple concentrated loads? What if we have continuous beam? What will happen? We will try to demonstrate now what if we have two concentrated loads. Okay? So, the idea is there. Then, as our tradition goes, you have been neurorized. See you in our next video lecture.